All right. Hello, everybody. Thank you so much for joining our webinar today. If you are brand new to SDocs, welcome. We are very excited to have you. And if you're already familiar with us, welcome back. My name is Zach Bruick. I'm the marketing manager here at SDocs. And today we're going to be talking about the basic first steps to take after downloading SDocs to get the most out of the product. With me here is Paul Burt, our senior solutions engineer, who is going to be presenting today. Paul, I will pass it over to you.
All right. Thank you, Zach. Hi there, everyone. This is Paul Burt with SDocs. And as Zach mentioned, the topic of today's webinar is I've downloaded SDocs. What's next? Now, as you might be familiar with, it's a very easy process to get SDocs installed into your Salesforce org, whether you're working in production or a sandbox. It really takes a matter of maybe 5 minutes to get the package installed. And the good news is that the configuration, once you have the application installed, is also quite straightforward. And that's exactly what we're going to cover for today. Now, some of the common questions that we see amongst our customer base and that you might be facing yourselves are listed out here. Now, first of all, we want to use the SDocs free version to develop a proof of concept, but we're not sure where to begin. Another common question is, how do we know if the free version is right for us? Moving on, we have another one here. We're looking to compare SDocs to another product, and we want to quickly install it and see what the capabilities look like. How do we start comparing? And finally, I love the reviews and downloaded the free version, but how do I make that first template? Now, really, in essence, all of these questions are asking the same exact thing. How do we get up and running with the SDoc solution? And here in just a minute, we will see exactly what it looks like to do so. But just for review's sake, what I'd like to start off with today is just a general reminder about where SDocs might be a relevant fit within the context of your organization. Now, at a very high level, SDocs is capable of taking data from anywhere in Salesforce and transforming it into a dynamic document. Now, that document can mean a lot of different things. It might be a PDF, might be an Excel sheet, might even be something as dynamic as a PowerPoint. There are many different forms of documents that SDocs is capable of generating. And again, at a high level, we can take that information and create documents using it. Now, SDocs has a lot of other very advanced functionalities like document automation, e-signature, bulk document generation, and more. But to achieve those sophisticated, fancy functionalities, we, of course, have to get up and running with the basics. And that's what we're going to cover for today. So first of all, let's think about what being a native application means. This means that when you're using SDocs, your data is completely contained to the confines of your own Salesforce instance. At no point will data leave your system to process on external servers. And really, SDocs is the only document generation application that is true for. Literally all other document generation and e-signature solutions available within the Salesforce marketplace do require sending your data outside of the system for external processing, and then that information has to be returned back to your instance of Salesforce. So really, where SDocs is a key application is anytime data security is top of mind. Now, with a native application, you are not introducing any data vulnerability when using a tool that is natively built. Another key element of our solution is the speed of which the documents generate. If your users get impatient sitting in front of a screen, waiting for a loading bar to complete or documents to generate, SDocs is a perfect fit because, as you'll see during today's demonstration, it's a nearly instantaneous process to actually generate the documents. But it's also a very quick process to stand up the templates and functionality that facilitate document generation. Now, another key area that I like to think of is the compatibility of our solution. As we know, Salesforce offers a lot of different functionality: Sales Cloud, Service Cloud, Communities, so on and so forth. And the more robust your Salesforce implementation is, the more benefit you can derive from using a tool like SDocs. Because SDocs is capable of integrating with really any of those Salesforce technologies, including things like Einstein, Lightning, even the upcoming Slack integrations that you may be hearing the buzz around recently. So again, if you are using a lot of different features and functionalities within Salesforce, I think you'll see that SDocs is capable of bringing a lot of value to the table because you can generate documents on any of those different environments that you might be leveraging. Now for today's agenda in the actual demonstration, the first thing that we're going to start out with is building an SDocs template within our template editor. Now, if you aren't familiar, the SDocs template editor is an in-browser point-and-click experience that is really designed to be picked up by someone who might not have much expertise in document generation whatsoever. Now, the second thing that we will cover is a new functionality that we offer that allows you to take an existing PDF template and quickly upload it so that you don't have to spend much time at all worrying about your document's formatting or creation. Third, we will go through and actually generate and send our first document via email. And finally, we will take a look at, you know, once we achieve this status of walk, how do we get to the phase of running? So that's what we will be covering for today. And without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into the actual live demonstration. Now, like I mentioned, for today's webinar, the first thing that we will do is explore what it looks like to create a brand new template. Now, to begin, what we will do is assume that we have SDocs already installed into our Salesforce instance. We will begin by navigating to this SDocs template object and clicking New to create our first template. In this case, I'm going to very creatively name it Webinar Test Template. And really, there's only a couple more things that we have to fill out. You'll see that there's a lot of optional metadata that you can use to tag up the document with different attributes, like which departments this might be relevant to, a description of what the template's purpose is, so on and so forth. But really, the key elements are these two fields that we see here. This first one denotes which object we are going to set the SDocs template up for. In this example, we will work with an opportunity, but keep in mind that really any Salesforce object is a valid candidate, including custom objects, external objects, even objects from other third-party applications. Now, the other thing here is the template format, and this controls the file type of the template that we are looking to produce. In this example, we will begin with PDF, but again, keep in mind that SDocs supports lots of other types, including Word documents, Excel sheets, and more. But now that we have these attributes set, let's go ahead and click Save. This creates the actual SDocs template record. And from here, really the important part is to actually go about building the document's contents. And to begin that process, we will click this template editor button that you see on the screen. Now this brings us into the in-browser point and click template builder. I think that building the templates is quite an intuitive process because really this is designed to look and feel like many other tools that you may be familiar with already. But if this was a brand new template, which in this case it is, I would start by adding any information that is not going to change from one document to the next. In this example, let's imagine that maybe we're generating a quote type document. Now, I can quickly just type in the text where it needs to appear, like you see here. Once we have our static text added into the document, we can use this toolbar to apply some formatting to it. Now, the lower segment of the toolbar is used for font attributes, things like font type and size, coloration, alignment, and so on. Again, pretty intuitive. This upper segment of the toolbar is used for other formatting elements, things like images, tables, and page breaks. So let's imagine that we also want to include maybe a logo file here at the very top of the page. We can just click to insert and it automatically shows us the various images that we have in our Salesforce system. And this is completely controllable as far as which images appear. But in this case, let's just go with the SDocs logo. We can quickly drag to resize this as desired, really no mystery in that regard. Now, the next thing that we'll include in our quote document here is maybe some information that is going to come from our base record directly. Now, I'll just add in some static text here, and let's say maybe opportunity amount is the field that we're looking to merge. Now that we have the text in here, really the important part is to map the dynamic data that needs to be brought from the record into our file. And to map that data is a very simple process. All we have to do is click Insert Field, and it is automatically going to show us all of the fields that exist on our base object. In this example, the opportunity. We would simply scroll through this list, find the desired field, click insert, and that's literally all that it takes to map the field. Now, that's what it looks like to grab a field from the base object directly, but let's imagine that in this case, since we're working with the opportunity object, maybe we actually need to include a field from the account. Let's call it the account name. Now, you might worry that SDocs is limited to only pulling fields from a single object at a time, but that's absolutely not the case. Let's go ahead and map this account name field. Again, all we have to do is click insert field and it will display the same exact list as before. But in this example, we are looking to access a field from the account object. Now you might notice that this phrase here has a greater than symbol next to it. Just like the Salesforce formula building experience, this denotes that when we click this entry, it's going to open that related object, in this example, the account, and all of its fields. Now we could keep traversing our data structure multiple levels deep using this point and click approach, but for simplicity's sake, let's just go ahead and choose account name, click insert, and again, that's all that it takes. Now you can imagine that adding more fields is really just a matter of repeating this process, so I won't go too much further on this topic. But the next thing that I'll show you is what it looks like to include a dynamic related list table. Now, when you think of an opportunity, really one of the most important things is the products or the opportunity line items that the customer is purchasing as denoted on the opportunity itself. Now, of course, that list is going to be variable. A customer might be purchasing only one product, or they might be purchasing more than 100. Therefore, we would want this table to be completely dynamic and automatically expand or contract. The good news is that's exactly what the SDocs related list functionality is intended to do. All we have to do here is click insert related list and begin by choosing which records need to populate our list. In this case, let's go with opportunity line items. We can then choose the fields that need to be displayed from each one of those line items, and you can choose one or as many as you need here, but I'll just go with a few as a sample. Let's see, so we had list price, quantity, we'll maybe go subtotal and total price, again, just for example's sake. And once our desired fields are chosen, we could use these tabs up above to add some more advanced functionality. Things like filtering this list out, changing the table that the data is placed into, as well as formatting the data in a specific way. But again, for today's purposes, let's keep it brief. I will just go ahead and click insert. This Zoom bar is, of course, in my way. And once we click insert, we will now see that this table header is added to the document. And again, keep in mind that when we generate this with data, there will be one row for each line item related to our specific opportunity. And the good news is that after we insert this, we still do have those point and click edit capabilities. We can do things like customizing the labels, updating the background color, and so on. But we will call this example good for now. Let's go ahead and click save. And at this point, the template is ready to be used. But before I show you this template in action, let's imagine that in addition to this quote that we've produced, maybe we also need to stand up a terms and conditions sheet. Now let's go ahead and create another SDocs template. Like I alluded to, we also have another type of template that allows you to upload a PDF rather than having to worry about any of the physical formatting in that point and click builder. Now, the point and click builder certainly is simple, but this is even more simple. The difference here is that we will choose PDF upload as our template type. And when we open up this editor, you'll see that it's really pretty dramatically different from what we just experienced. The first thing that we have to do is choose the PDF from our local device that needs to be uploaded as the actual document. And I'll go ahead and upload this relatively simple terms and conditions sheet. You'll see that it takes all of the formatting on this sheet, even if it had things like custom logos, headers and footers, custom coloration, and so on. It really doesn't matter what's present once we upload this. But now that it's uploaded, we will go ahead and click create another field to actually get some data mapped on top of this file. Now, this field selection process is very similar to what we saw before. We will simply scroll through, choose the desired field, and click insert. But the next step here is to take this blue tag that you see and drop it where that data actually needs to be included. And really, the remainder of setting this template up is just a matter of repeating this data mapping process that I just covered. But for today's purposes, we'll really just keep it at a single dynamic field and go ahead and click save. So now at this point, we have our two templates stood up, both a quote and the terms and conditions sheet that need to support the quote. So let's go and see this template in action. Now, of course, I'm going to navigate over to an opportunity record. And if this was a brand new implementation of SDocs, the other thing you would have to do is add this SDocs button onto your page. But the good news is that the SDocs button comes pre-configured with our package for all of the different standard objects that you might be looking to use. Adding it onto or making it available to your users is really just a matter of editing the desired page layout and dragging the SDocs button where it needs to appear. Now you'll see, of course, that I've already added it onto my page, but that's pretty much all you have to do to get to the point that we see here. Now at this stage, let's go ahead and click this SDocs button, and this is going to allow us to choose from the different templates that we have in our org. I will choose both of the two templates that we just stood up here, click next step, and at this point, it's going to, well, of course, I guess that's the hazard of generating a document live and on the fly. I must have been fat fingered in some regard. But what we will do instead, actually, is let's just go ahead and generate maybe this other template that I know should work. And then we will also choose that same webinar terms and conditions sheet. Here we go. And now that they're selected, again, click next step. Now, hopefully this time it works. Again, the hazard of doing things live, but at this stage, it should be taking the data from the record, merging it into the template, and actually producing the output file. Now, this certainly looks a lot better than the quote that we just provided, but again, you know, the concept is exactly the same. This one just had a little more TLC in advance compared to the one that we just spun up. But as you can see, we've brought a lot of different data from the opportunity record into our template file, including fields from the opportunity, the account, metadata, as well as related lists. Here's our table that shows us all of the line items related to our specific opportunity. So really, that's what it looks like to stand up SDocs and test it out in a quick use case. But really, the next question might be, how do we take this document and actually deliver it to a customer? And if that's a requirement of yours, this is really where the premium version of SDocs becomes relevant. Because just for information's sake, there is a free version of SDocs available on the AppExchange. I highly recommend trying it out. But the free version is limited to only two templates. Now, if two templates is all your organization requires, then by all means, you're able to use the free version of SDocs. But what we have experienced is that certainly organizations have far more documents than just two. So you might use a couple templates to get up and running, but I think you'll really quickly see that you either have the need for more documents or for more advanced functionality. Now, one of those advanced functionalities is the ability to take a document and send it via email. In this case, I'm going to choose a PDF, same as before, but I'm also going to choose an email template to go along with it. Now, once I click next step, it's going to generate the documents, just like we saw earlier. But once these generate, we're going to take the additional step of clicking this email selected docs button that will appear. And once we click this button, it leads our user to the SDocs email interface. Now you'll see that almost all of the information on this page is pre-populated for our user, and this is simply using the contents of that email template. Now, this is very similar in concept to a Salesforce email template, really just with expanded capabilities. Since this is ultimately an SDocs template, you can make this email look and feel however you would like from a branding perspective. You can also merge in data from anywhere in Salesforce, just like the first PDF example. You can even get more advanced with it and perform translations on the fly, include conditional sections, and so on and so forth. But the other benefit here is that the email template can also key in information automatically for our user. And certainly that reduces the amount of time that we have to spend on this screen, as well as the amount of the possibility of mistake from manually typing things in. But now that we're satisfied with this email, let's go ahead and click send. And at this stage, we should have a document that has been delivered to the intended recipient. Now, the last part of this equation is where do these documents store? And you'll see that in this SDocs list, we have both the PDF and the email that we just generated automatically connected. SDocs can also store the document to other locations like files, attachments, and third-party systems. And the email itself is also tracked back at the record level. Now, that's what it looks like to use SDocs in a premium capacity. In this case, we took the document and actually delivered it via email. But there certainly are a lot of other premium functionalities that we do support. One great example is electronic signature. S-Sign is our own in-house e-sign product that we have built from the ground up. And just like SDocs, it is completely native to Salesforce, which brings, again, the added benefit of security, speed, compatibility, and so on. Now, another advanced premium feature that we do support is document automation. In everything that we've seen today, the user had to begin the process by clicking the SDocs button that was placed on our page. But if your organization requires a document being produced automatically or without the user clicking the SDocs button, then that again means that you're a great candidate for the premium version of SDocs. And by the way, that document can generate based on Salesforce information updating, timing rules, and a variety of other drivers. And again, there are a couple other premium features to keep in mind, like batch document generation, the ability to send multiple templates at once, and so on. But really, that's what it looks like to get up and running with the SDocs solution. Now, just coming back to our slideshow here, a couple of resources that I'll point out for you to actually perform what I just did are listed out here. Now, one of those resources is the template library. And actually, I'll toggle over to this template library because personally, I think this is a fantastic way to kickstart your testing process. These are templates that are available at sdocs.com that you can simply download and use in your org in a matter of minutes, if not seconds. Now, this has a variety of different types of documents like quotes, invoices, even letters, summaries, so on and so forth. I highly encourage people to come here and check it out because there's a good chance that your type of document has already been built by our team and is publicly available. But there are some other resources to keep in mind, like the videos that are on our website, as well as the knowledge base. Now, both of these contain a lot of information on the various features and functionalities. They're also set up in a guided way so that it leads you down a logical path, starting with basic functions like we performed today and scaling in to those more advanced functionalities. And really, that leads me through everything that I had planned to present for today. So at this point, I would like to open it up for questions if there are any, Zach.
Thank you, Paul. We have had a few questions come in throughout the webinar, as well as a few emailed to us beforehand. So I'll go through a couple of those now. Starting off, we have a few similar questions. So what if we need attributes merged in to a document from multiple objects? How do we do that? And is that possible?
Yeah, that is a great question. And that is absolutely possible. You can merge objects from, or you can merge fields from any object inside of Salesforce. And you can also merge multiple objects worth of data into a single PDF file. If we think back to the example that I prepared at the beginning of today's call, we were bringing in fields from both the opportunity and the account into the same document. Now, that's a simple example, but again, you can scale far beyond that if you need to summarize tens of objects into a single document. And the other thing that I might not have pointed out is that SDocs can grab data from literally anywhere in Salesforce, even if it's completely unrelated to your base record. Now, there aren't a lot of real-life scenarios where that would be relevant, but from a technical perspective, if the data is in Salesforce, SDocs can grab it.
Great. We have another question here. How are SDocs exposed in communities or sites?
Yeah, that's a great question. So it is completely up to you in terms of what level of access you want to give to the community users. But from a technical perspective, really anything that a regular internal Salesforce user can do could also be performed by a community user. whether that's generating a document for e-signature through the context of a portal that they sign within the portal itself, or even building their own templates. Now, I'm not sure why you would want a community user to build their own templates, but if your organization requires it, that's certainly a capability. So really, the short answer is anything that a typical user can do can also be performed in the community, of course, if you give the community users access.
Great. Now we have another question here. How does the DocX format work?
Yeah, good question. So that's a type of template that I didn't really get into today. But the DocX type of template allows you to build the template from the ground up in a Word file. Now, keep in mind that we also have other types of templates that let you build it in Excel as well as PowerPoint. But ultimately, you're building the template itself in a tool that your users are familiar with, like Word. You tag it up using a very similar process to what we see today. And once all of the merge fields are included in your Word file, you simply upload it to the SDoc system and the template is ready to go. Now, the perk of that, of course, is that you can use a tool that you're already very intimately familiar with, like Microsoft Word, rather than having to learn one that's, you know, slightly new.
Wonderful. Thanks, Paul. Another question is, could this replace our Adobe Sign?
Yeah, that's a great question. And as long as your users need to generate signature requests within the context of Salesforce, then the answer is absolutely yes. Now, like I mentioned, S-Sign is native to Salesforce. So if you need to generate a signature request from a system outside of Salesforce, that would really be the only scenario where S-Sign would not be a valid candidate. But as long as everything is based in Salesforce, you can absolutely use S-Sign to replace really any other tool.
Great. Now, another question here. Someone asked, if I need to generate and send out a couple hundred custom documents or emails at once, can SDoc support that?
Yes, absolutely. So we do have a functionality called Mass Merge. Now, thinking back to our earlier example, we navigated to a single record and generated a document within the context of that one record alone. But there are plenty of scenarios where you might want to perform that same action in mass. The example that I like to think of is maybe we're sending out customer communications to hundreds and hundreds of customers. Rather than having to open up those customers and records one at a time and perform the action, let's call it 200 times, Mass Merge allows you to do it all with a single workflow. You simply navigate to a Salesforce list view, select the records that you would like to generate a document for, click a button, and the documents are produced in bulk. Now, Mass Merge also lets you mass email those documents out. You can even integrate it with the ability to print off mailing labels and envelopes if your use case necessitates physical printing and delivery.
Thank you, Paul. Really appreciate it. Unfortunately, we are running out of time here. I know we have other questions. I'm going to pass it back over to Paul, and he will tell you how to contact us with those additional questions.
Well, thank you, Zach, and thank you everyone for the time and the attention today. Those were some great questions. Now, since there are questions that we did not have time to get to today, I highly recommend that people reach out to us, and we're happy to answer those questions, really whatever they might be. And you can reach out to us by contacting this email address that we see here, sales@sdocs.com. And again, we're happy to answer any of those questions that you might have. And I think that does it for the webinar for today. So again, I just want to extend a sincere thank you to everyone for your time and taking some time out of your busy schedules. But I look forward to hopefully hearing some more questions from the group shortly.